Green Man Gaming, it calls for you because it is neat. And you should go and use our coupon code for 20% off all of your purchases store-wide. And sometimes you can even stack a sale price on top of it. Head to the links below.
That's fun.
Hello, audience! Hunter here, and welcome to the most obscure game that's... It's actually impossible to find this game. It is actually impossible to find this game. It can't be done. Because, this is a game that was meant to run on a thing that looks like this. I do have to emulate this one. But... Oh, that is actually quite loud. Where's the emulator? Ah, here it is. Okay, so, this is Ratchet and Clank going mobile. Okay, where do I be? Alright. I first learned about this game back when I got Ratchet and Clank, up your arsenal, where they had an ad for this game. But I didn't own a phone at the time, so I couldn't play it. And then, like, freaking these phones became a thing of the past, and then I never got to play it, and nobody got to play it, and it faded into obscurity. But here it is. What's interesting about this game is that IGN gave it like an 8.3, I think? 8-something, I don't know. Alright, save slot. Biomatter converter technology. Okay. Invited to preview as accidentally... I love how he doesn't have enough room to say his entire sentence. And that means converted to digital Okay, so when the ad said that he was stuck in my phone, it literally meant, like, that's the story. He's stuck in my phone. Oh, good. And stored within the converter. Wait. The SJ Boy emulator is the converter? Huh. Need to look for... Press OK or the 5 key to attack with your wrench. Okay, good, so it works with the number keys. I have no idea how long this game is. He was just moving on his own. Info link that connects the area with the rest of the galaxy's information network will take us to another electron, blah, 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 blah. Okay. He's still moving on his own. Press the 8 key on this teleporter... I should be using the keypad, but... Oh, no, wait. I'm not recording with fraps. Alright, fuck it. I'm gonna use the keypad. Wait, this is all of the levels? It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17? 17?! Jesus Christ, mobile games nowadays don't have this much... depth. Oh dear. Yes, it looks familiar. It looks like a casino. The device we have been carried to is a vid comic, specifically a Secret Agent Clank vid comic. Oh good. I was gonna ask if he had ammo for the weapon. Wait, oh, not a lot. Press OK or the 5 key to fire the Lancer. Alright. Wait, can he, like, no, but he has the, I was about to say, can he double jump? No, but he does have, ooh, wall jumping. To unlock a door, hit the bolt with your wrench. Okay. Shit. Okay, so, alright, for a second there, I thought we were gonna have bolt cranks, but no. Oh, the cheesy sound effects. I feel like I'm playing one of those, we do everything, anything and everything, indie games. Jump towards a wall and press up, or the 2 key. Okay. That's actually not as bad as I thought it would be. That is actually not that bad. It looks like bolts are in this game. Interesting. Can grind on rails by jumping onto them. Try grinding on this rail. Yay! Doesn't have the same satisfying, grind boot sound effect, though. In fact, I don't think it has a sound effect at all! So why are we fighting the chicken bots from, Ratchet and Clank 2? This is software can use to extend my arms so the so as to wait, what? Okay, wait, in this game they call it the grapple gun? I thought Insomniac made this. I am fairly certain that Insomniac made this game. Press up or two to extend. Wait, so now it's worth noting that despite this game, like, trying its very best to fade into obscurity, this game is canon. Like, it happened within the timeline. I believe it was, they said it was a little bit after, I don't have any means of dodging that attack. I believe it was a little bit after Up Your Arsenal that they said that this game was. You don't have to consider them canon. Like, you don't have to consider any of them canon by any means, but I guess you have to consider the first game canon. That's, like, kind of a requirement. But Lord knows, we don't want Size Matters to be canon. We don't! Jesus Christ. It doesn't help that these guys don't die. Fuck. Yay, I'm good. Bolts. There's a lot of crates here. Oh my god. Why does he stand still for a little bit after that? I'm at 1,000 bolts. I don't know if that's a lot for this game. I don't know. I've never played this game. Never had the opportunity. I'm pretty sure it also, like, this was back when mobile games actually cost money. Because, you know, they were actually gonna give it, like, some substance, other information, blah, 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 blah. Unlock level 2! Yay. Killed 13 enemies. Oh, good. Wait, titanium bolts? Huh. Cool. Yeah, no, say. Hey! It's that fucking sound effect. Like, it's, like, horribly bit crushed, but. There. Oh, so we have to go over here for the weapons store. Buy ammo. Okay, so we got the gravity bomb, the mini rocket, oh, these aren't available yet. Here we go, buy ammo for all guns! This costs 800, and these two aren't available yet. Looks like there's only, like, 2 other slots. Okay, now. Actually, max out the ammo. Okay, now, how do I exit this? Can I, like, that doesn't work. Maybe backspace? No. Oh, wait. It's supposed to be, like, the blue buttons are supposed to be, this is how you buy, and this is how you do the other thing. Gonna try shift. Shift? Is it shift? Control! Is it enter? You'd really think that it'd be backspace, wouldn't it? Hey! Oh, okay, I can click it. You gotta click the buttons. Here, check it out. Yay! Alright, what the hell is Battleland? Oh, yes! Posters that say ACE! It's worth noting that I can barely see this game. It's really small. Oh, come on, chicken bots never took this many hits to die! Ever! In fact, the chicken bot was a one-hit enemy! Alright, jump right on top of this guy and kill him. Yeah! Yes, and I'd slowly glide down to the ground. Not gonna lie, this is actually surprisingly playable. Like, even with me using the goddamn keyboard and I am using the mouse, aren't I? I'll give you a complaint, though. You want a complaint? Okay. The attack button and the, use wrench button are the same button. That's a lot of spikes. That will probably kill me. That is the fuck it. The goddamn swing shot is, like, the most underwhelming thing. Holy shit! No, I was right! The swing shot, it makes its way into every single Ratchet and Clank game. Even the ones that have died! Which is... well, it's pretty much this one. Wait, this has an arena? Okay! Guess I'll check that out. Kill all enemies to beat the arena level. Holy shit, you added replayability to this. Why can't mobile games nowadays have the... why can't we, like, report this to, like, report this to, current-gen phones? Don't answer that. Current-day phones don't have buttons. They don't. They don't have buttons. It's like the phones were just, like, we want to shun buttons. And any amount of quality put into games whatsoever. That is every mobile game. Okay, so this level is built like a... where am I going? Found one. What the... wait, did I win? I guess so. Communication station. It rhymes. Alright, so there are 4 platinum bolts in that, 3 in that, and 2 in this. Wow. Okay, there's a lot of platinum bolts. Let's see. Also, wait, platinum bolt. This came out after, Up Your Arsenal. In that game, it was titanium bolts. Why isn't it titanium bolts? I don't know. The development of this game start before, that'd be ridiculous. That would be absolutely ridiculous. Also stupid. Because I'd imagine that the console release, the console game, Ratchet and Clank, Up Your Arsenal. Oh, I'm dead. Like, the console game, Ratchet and Clank, Up Your Arsenal. Like, one of my absolute favorite games of all time. Took considerably more effort than a game meant to run on a Nokia phone. Welcome to, like, the back end of obscure games, ladies and gentlemen. Like, this is just a game that disappeared off the map. Alright, you want another complaint? I can't fire down. I can't shoot up, can't shoot down. Oh boy. I gotta move with the platforms, which is more than I could say for some games. Then again, this was like Insomniac is like, well, Insomniac's still making the games, but I don't know. Ah! Wait, no, wait a minute! Oh, that's not fair! How come he can fire down? Bastard! I'll fucking kill you! Yeah. Fuck! Hey, checkpoint. Wait. Oh wow, the checkpoint was right there. Oh, what? I'm sure it was a disappointment. I'm stuck underneath it. Trying to wrench the bastard. I can't move. There we go. What the? Ah! It's disorienting when the screen, like, just changes like that. I'm not keeping this door closed. Oh, good. Unlock level 4! And then you have the option to replay the level. It boggles my mind that there's this many levels in a mobile phone game from 10 years ago! This game is 10 years old. I think. Here, hold on, I got the wiki open. Ratchet and Clank going mobile. Ratchet and Clank Collection, Clone Home, that's the one that they apparently cancelled. Alright, Going Mobile came out... Oh no, this is 2005! So this is 11 years old! Oh. Okay, so apparently this wasn't developed by Insomniac, nor High Impact Games, and... Lord knows we don't want high-impact games making, Ratchet and Clank games. So who did make this? A company called Handheld Games! I guess you didn't really need to be that creative back then, it was Nokia phones. Jesus. Why? Freaking! Why is that your name? It shouldn't be your name. There's 10 billion like more creative names. Wow. That's weird. You have one sound effect. I guess because the games were small as hell. Sonic versus holds as a strike is very tenuous. What? Oh, that. Oh, okay. Fuck! Where am I? Okay, I'm not that far back. Okay, so jumping obstacles. Alright. I should have expected them to add that, but I didn't. How fast can this thing shoot? Decent. I want everything here. All of it. I guess I'm not going that way. Yay! This is what I want. A four-piece swing shot. Make me nervous. Freaking switch. I know this game is calling it something else, but... no, it's the same basic principle. That's a swing shot. The fucking swing shot has become, like... Just such a you know what I should do? You know what I should do? I should just do one of those fact videos for Ratchet and Clank. I'm obviously the most qualified person to do it. I probably don't even have to do much research for it. I went to the wrong level. Back. Alright, start hitting buttons. There's exit game. Mission objective, kill or be killed. Anyway, can't tell you that. Okay. Stop that! Alright, we need to go here. That's a bolt. It looks like a cube. Okay, the bolts look like cubes. Like that one right there, that looks like a cube. That one right there, it looks like a cube. That one there also looks like a cube. Also, what is up with this backdrop? So, handheld games. What exactly, did you end up doing? Alright, well, the Ratchet & Clank wiki page doesn't say anything. It just says that they developed the game and they were gonna develop this game's sequel. This mobile phone game was gonna have a sequel, but they canceled it. Don't know why. I don't know. I don't know if this game did well. I know that it was very highly rated. Like, part of me, like, looking at this game, I just look at it and I'm like, this is what mobile phone games used to be. It was none of this microtransaction flooded bullshit. Sure, you might have had a couple, or like reoccurring payments that were charged to your like data plan, but oh, I'm dead. But it was better. It was better. Can I actually hold this above some? I think I hold this game above Angry Birds, actually. Angry Birds is a worse game than this. Every game that has microtransactions in it on the mobile platform is worse than this. Cause like, it's not like, it's not like you're building something, or like a town, or a vault, or Ponyville, or a fucking dungeon. Oh, why am I even comparing this game to Dungeon Keeper Mobile, or fucking Roller Coaster Tycoon Mobile, or shit like that? Cause like that shit floods the market now, and then here's a scenario for you. Actually, I got one right here. I don't know if this works. This is a Verizon phone. It's a Samsung phone, but it's a flip phone. If I could get it working, I could probably play this game. But the thing is, you're used to playing all those games, right? But then, like, out of nowhere, you find an old Nokia phone that still works. And you boot it up, and it has, like, I don't know, something like this on it. And you play it, and it's like, this is actually enjoyable. This is what the mobile platform could have been. I'm sorry if I'm going off on a bit of a tangent, or whatever that word is, but this is what the mobile market has become. I completely despise mobile games, and on that note, I also completely despise mobile gamers. like people who say I'm a mobile gamer, and I'm like, no, that is not a form of gamer. Go die, or no, I wouldn't tell them to die. I'd probably tell them to go like pick up at least a goddamn Nintendo 3D fucking S. Cause like then like if you were a bit. If you're big on, like, the handhelds, like the PSP or the DS, then that's fine. You can call yourself a mobile gamer. But, like you're like, I'm a mobile gamer. Here's my fucking iPhone 82. And I'm like, okay, or you're the scourge of society because you give in to all of the microtransactions. Holy shit, this is one of the greatest Ratchet and Clank games ever. Hey, it's Al! I miss that guy! Holy shit! Ratchet and Clank going mobile may very well be the most important mobile game ever created, ever. Because... tell your friends about this game, you can emulate it easily enough, but, like, play this. Or, like, get an old flip phone, if you still have a flip phone, play this. And then, be depressed at this is what the mobile market has become. Because, like, holy shit. This game. Wow. Okay. Blah, 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 need to determine how to reverse the process. Well, that's easy. All you need to do is run your digital corporeal data through the macrocorporeal geal fragmentation ion negator. Or MacGuffin. Ah! Got a terrible taste in my mouth right there. But the MacGuffin. Okay. There was no word in there that starts with U, so it's just lowercase. That reminds me of, fucking, what was it? Calvin and Hobbes. Their fake club called, GROSS, which was an acronym for Get Rid of Slimy Girls. But the S at the end was for the S in girls. This will reverse the biodigitization process and return you to the analog realm. He is floating midair as he's talking to Al. Once a nerd, always a nerd. You build robots, Ratchet. You fix spaceships. You cannot. And where might we find this MacGuffin? I have one right here. I use it for a doorstop. Okay, how is that gonna help us here? Perhaps Big Al? When was he ever Big Al? Was it Big Al's RoboShack? Okay. Al can bring it to the biomatter converter station and send it through to us. but tonight is my Amoeboids and... anti-chambers game. We are in urgent need of help here. Blah, 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 blah. Oh, apparently I beat the level. This thing even lets you save! Why are there two battle lands? So I guess this is the same reason as to why there are two battle lands is because there's also two circuits. Oh, no, wait. The same level, I think. Like, both of these are the communication station, both of these are battle land, and both of these are circuit. Man, if we get enough circuits around here, we could have a circuit city. what do we have here? I have no idea what that thing is right there. This game doesn't look terrible either. I'm looking at this. If you told me that an indie developer, nowadays made this, and it was intended to be played on this small of a screen, I'd probably believe you, if I didn't know any better. I got stuck. Yeah, I'd probably believe you if I didn't know that this game already existed. You can go to Circuit Circuit. Wait, oh my god, it's, I think that's Max Million. He's in the third game. Yeah. This is why I should do the... This is why I should totally do the, facts of, Ratchet and Clank. You know what, fuck it, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do it! It's gonna happen! I had to... Let's face it, I am the most qualified person to do it. In the world. Probably the most qualified person to do it. Because now with this, I've played every Ratchet and Clank game that's come out. Aside from Quest for Booty, I still need to get that. Also, All for One. Didn't play that one. Okay, and Full Frontal Assault. But I played the important ones. Into the Nexus. You know, that one. That's a good one. It actually is a good one. Okay, Into the Nexus is short, but it's an absolutely fantastic game while it lasts. And it actually does work. And it's got me anxiously awaiting the next one. Whatever the next one might be, I don't know what it's gonna be. Freaking, I don't know. I don't know what it's gonna be. Like, Insomniac, I don't even know if they've even started planning for the next game. I don't even know if they're gonna do a next game, honestly. They probably would, because the Ratchet and Clank games keep being good. They keep being good, and this thing right here just proves that, whatever platform they move to, it's always gonna be good. Except Size Matters, which was... terrible idea, poor execution, wrong company, and terrible storyline. We'll get into Size Matters later, though. Something seems to have happened. There only seems to be a piece of the device here. There's a message here. I'll play it. I tried running the MacGuffin through the big matter converter, but there was an error in the transmission. A power surge caused it to split into six pieces, and each was sent to a different VidCom issue. In order to get them, you'll have to pay $20 for each level or wait a full 24 hours. That's what they would do. That's what they do nowadays. Cause like, no. Okay, I'm going back to my ranting. Freaking, Dungeon Keeper Mobile. One of the main things with the original Dungeon Keeper was clearing out rock, and most of the rock on the map takes 24 hours to clear, or you can pay microtransactions.
Isn't that nice?
Oh, we are good game devs. Thanks for fucking completely fucking over the Dungeon Keeper franchise. Also, was it Atari? I don't know. Someone fucked over Roller Coaster Tycoon. No to you, but you'll have to find the six pieces to reassemble it. Is today a Monday? I hate Mondays. Dialogue is something to something of note that's bad, but I don't hate it. Let's see, received item 1 and unlocked level 6. Item 1. They called it item 1. Okay. Ooh, I completed that in 1 minute 50 seconds. And I needed to complete it in 2 minutes 40 seconds. Game has been saved. You know, I haven't done it in a while. Gone to the, these unlocked yet? Yeah, they are. I just remembered I haven't been using the gravity bomb. The gun, do the guns upgrade in this? Oh, that'd be awesome if the guns upgraded in this game. Oh. Alright, gotta find the back button. Hold, fuck it, I'll just click. Alright, where are we going? Burnout Munderbowl. Okay. That's a word. You know what I haven't figured out yet? Alright. I'm gonna try every button. Alright. So 4 and 6 move the guy. 2 does nothing. That's another jump button. That's a jump in that direction button. That's just a plain old jump button. 5 is the fire button. This phone does not have a lot of buttons, game. No, continue. Okay, so that opens up the same menu. What about this button? That's the... Alright, alright. Come down here with me to the keypad, ladies and gentlemen. Let's try the buttons. That's what 1 does. 2, 3, 4 moves. 5 is attack. 6, move that way. 7, 8, 9. Number... There! I was looking for this! The number pad is the quick select. Okay. Now, how do I select a weapon? To the keypad. Oh, wait. I just do that? Alright, so that's how I select the ones up top. It looks like there are, 7 weapons in this game. Lancer. Let's try the mini rocket. Which button is that on, the keypad? Okay, that... Ah! Okay, it's the, divide key. Interesting choice. Alright. Where am I going? What am I doing here? Ah! Fuck you. Fuck that. Really? They use the same sound effect for the... It's the Lancer for the rocket launcher. I'm dead. How restrictive was the storage space back then? I have to see what the gravity bomb does. Okay, so that's just like... It's the same sound effect, but it attacks over a larger area. Okay. That's interesting. Hey! I found it super fair that, enemies are able to attack me before I can even see them. Hold on. No, hey! Navigating this game is, well, it's something of note. Please be platform. That's not a platform! Oh, yes. Really? You don't even give me 2 seconds. Don't even give me 2 seconds to think about what I'm doing. Why? Does that add to the challenge of it? The replayability? Because, honestly, I consider this game to have more re... How am I supposed to get up there? Wait. When he dies, does it... I could vaguely hear, the noise that he plays when he gets hit. In, like, the regular games. Fuck's sake! Wait. Hey, wait. I had to take damage? But, I question. I like that they have the G boxes. I haven't seen G boxes since the original games. I don't remember what they were in the future series. I know for a fact that in the future series they went over to Grubblenet. And that's what and that was the weapons dealer. The weapons dealer. I make it sound like a bad thing. They sold you the weapons! I don't think any way I word this is gonna sound good. Ah. I'm not even frustrated. Like, the game is forgiving. That's another thing with today's mobile market. Games are stupid and unforgiving. It's like, oh, you wanted to build the Quickie Mart in Simpsons Tapped Out. That's gonna take 8 hours. But don't worry, you can pay 500 in-game money to have it built instantly. That's gonna run you about $5, but we recommend you get the $500 money pack to get the best out of your deal. You know what? I look at microtransactions like that, like the great big $500 ones. And I look at that, and I just say to myself, someone out there actually paid for that. Alright, someone out there actually paid for that. The $500 money pack. I just realized I had it like this. I'm sorry. Someone out there went and bought that $500 worth of in-game currency to spend on a mobile game. And the $500 is probably going to last you about, I don't know, 2 hours tops. Because you're going to burn through it like fucking paper. Like fire burns through paper. And, like, then chances are he's never going to play it again. Ergo, he just wasted $500. I could go to Disneyland for $500. I could pay for the entirety of what I have to pay for at BronyCon. That's hotel, tickets, spending money, market budget as in the freaking, like, plushies and stuff. Freaking everything! If I drove, it would even cover the gas money! I could probably put a down payment on a fucking car! And I'm gonna get way more use out of that than $500 worth of in-game currency. Oh, wow. I think the world needs to see, I think the world needs, you know what, how can I word this? The mobile market needs to take a look back. They need to take a look back, and they need to, I can't get up here. And it teleports me right there. I can't get up here. Wait, surprised I haven't hit the spike. Fuck! That was the spikes! Yes! Fucking finally! What was I saying? The mobile market needs to take a look back at their Nokia phones and be like, huh, so this is what it used to be. Not gonna lie, this is actually pretty good. That's what needs to happen. And, like, freaking, and, and this was back when the market, like, this was back when, like the mobile market and the gaming market wasn't like we opened the goddamn floodgates and let any goddamn piece of crap game in. That's all your and like that goes for all of your Flappy Bird clones, all your goddamn Steam has this same issue. That goes for the bastards at Digital Homicide. Fucking the guy behind Air Control and the uncreative people behind Goat Simulator. This game is probably going to destroy the mobile market. And I don't care! Like, there is a... What the fuck am I supposed to do here, actually? Do I do something with this thing? There are only so many buttons. I have no idea. Anyway, but no. I believe that the mobile market needs to take a great big step back and have a look back at what they put on their Nokia phones. And then they should cry. Because what they have here is vastly superior. That was Ratchet and Clank going mobile. And it's a better game than pretty much every game on mobile devices. Thanks for watching, guys. And I will see you in the next video.